Okay, here we go. The last part. We established in the last video that in the first section, we're speeding up, then we move at a constant velocity, because remember, this is a VT graph, and then we speed up again. So I'm going to draw my DT and VT graphs for that. So DT, it's not going to be negative because nothing has to do that. So we're going to start with that. We're going to label it as a DT graph. And then we're going to think about speeding up. We're starting down here because we're moving away. We know we're moving away because it's all in the positive quadrant, right? So we're going to start off here. We're going to start off flat. Curve, and then we're going to go constant. So the constant part I'm going to do as a line just to make it nice and constant. So then I have a constant speed. Remember, this is a sketch, so we're not going to get excited about its exact shape. We're just showing we understand. And then it speeds up again, so we go back to the curve, right? Make sure it looks nice and curved. Little curves a bit back on itself, but not too bad. We'll just take that bit out. That's basically the general understanding. That's all we're trying to show. Curve, flat, curve. It shows I understand the shape. That's all you're trying to communicate. Now, when we go to do the AT, the acceleration time, it's not so bad. Because when I go to find the acceleration time, sketch the acceleration time, I just have to think about those same three things. It was going constant, speeding up, constant, speeding up. And the whole thing was moving away because it was all in the positive. And if you look at that graph, when we go back up and look at the graph in a second, let me just make this an AT. That doesn't look much like an A, but you have to believe me. So if we go back up to the top, then you will notice that I have a positive slope, no slope, positive slope. And that's all I really need for my AT, is to say whether there's a slope or not. So I have a positive slope, I have no slope, and then I have a positive slope again. Now, if we look at those slopes, the first one is steeper than the second one. So we'll make this second one a little bit lower to show we understand that part, that the acceleration the second time is not as high. Now you'll notice it seems to kind of stop in the middle of nowhere, but it isn't stopping in the middle of nowhere. At the end of the graph, it is still accelerating. So I'm just going to make these stand out so people can see it better, and we're good. We've drawn our AT graphs. Remember, these take some practice. Be kind to yourself. Be patient. The more you practice, the better it is.